What makes the model of Parker Street Ministries unique, it's relationship first.
If we have any marker of success for anything that we've done, with any of the resources that we've had, it would be maintaining those relationships.
Love my neighbor and be with them. I can do that. And I can do that from now until I'm dead. You know, I mean, that's an actual attainable goal. And in that, fruit happens. I mean, real fruit.
One of my favorite things about the neighborhood and Parker Street Ministries is just the community. There's something so unique about the connections that are made that just make you want to keep coming back.
We do like a big Easter egg hunt, or in the summertime, big pool parties with big water slides, giving out free food. Anyone's allowed to join in the fun, so it's really a sense of community here at Parker Street.
There's a place for everyone to serve, but it really doesn't have to be a huge change. There's just so many small ways to help and to partner with Parker Street.
The church gets to, in this case, enter into a larger story of what God is doing and other people that have been involved for a long period of time. And you get to just come alongside that whole transformation process that's already happening.
The one thing that I love at Parker Street is the Christmas store. Communities, businesses, churches, everyone comes together. They bring in gifts that parents and kids can buy for their loved ones at a discounted price. And it really reaffirms the dignity that these people have already. There's a lot of places for people to plug in. If you're a behind the scenes person, you can be pricing, sorting, doing all kinds of stuff. You can be out front helping kids. There's a spot for everyone. And it's just an awesome opportunity for Parker Street to love and bless the community. We have families that rearrange their Christmas vacations to come serve at the Christmas store. They love it that much.
While we do get the luxury of providing some aid, providing some resources, providing some real change, a lot of our incarnational work is walking step by step alongside one another in the mess of life.
We're here as neighbors, and so we can come together and share a meal. And last time we put up posters and just kind of wrote, how's everyone doing? What's going on? What are some of the needs and the issues? I think it just helped all of us realize that we're not alone in it.
We have this beautiful facility that is very functional for a lot of things, but what we do know is the early years when there was no big facility and everyone had to go to each other's houses, there was a depth in those relationships that happened in the living rooms that we started to lose when we had the institutional structure. We came up with this idea from other people that do this, basically just taking a house and turning it into an intentional space of gathering for neighborhood residents. There's someone there that is able to say, how you doing? What's going on? Is there a way I can help you? It's a place for people to watch the news. It's just a place for people to check in and find out what's happening in the neighborhood. There will be food in the refrigerator that can be easily warmed up, and you can just say, hey, it's lunchtime, let's eat lunch. Based on how we've seen community developed over the years, I really believe this is a great tool that God could use